really conscious about how we spend our money. So I say I want to save up for a house. I say I want to save for retirement, and yet I'm going out and I'm spending money on drinks, on a fancy new car, and I'm making choices that don't serve my long-term values or my long-term goals. And to start to get more in integrity, so when I'm spending that money, I can say, yeah, this actually serves towards my abundance, my happiness, or whatever it might be that I'm saying I want.
Has COVID helped people reevaluate themselves in these spheres?
Absolutely. When COVID first hit, a lot of my clients called up and in a panic. Oh my God, we're going to go bankrupt. We're going to lose everything. About 6 months in, a lot of my clients were saying, oh my gosh, I have more money. I'm not going out to restaurants 5 nights a week. I'm actually getting to know these little kids called children in my house that I didn't really know that well. And so it's really made people, I think, be forced to figure out what's important and what's not. And spouses are having to spend time with each other when they got to, in the past, just go to work and avoid certain conversations. So I think it's really amplified a lot of things for people.
Are those good things? In great respect, or has it turned out to be a bad thing?
Well, I think in the long run, it's always a good thing, even when you find the bad stuff. But I definitely think there are certainly relationships have ended because things have been amplified. And I think other relationships have been tightened and enhanced. In either way, I think it's great information to have to do a lot of self-reflecting, even if it wasn't necessarily by choice.
Yes, reflecting is part of this, and that's how you... So are there some schemas or techniques that you advocate for people to start this reflection process?
Absolutely. So I'm a big believer in journaling as a way to start. Now, it's not for everybody, but I do find there is power in writing things down. A couple things. Figure out my history. What's my story? Was I the rich kid? Was I the poor kid? Was I the one in having hand-me-down clothes? What are the stories I created around that? And then starting to write down, what did mom, dad say about money? What did they not say about money? What did they model? What did I pick up on that? What were some of my first money experiences? Were they positive or negative? Did I lose the milk money? All those things that we took on when we were 4, 5, and 6. If we start journaling that down and start becoming aware, we can really connect with, oh, that's where that comes from. And so then we can really, we don't have to shame ourselves. We don't have to judge ourselves. We can just say, oh, isn't that interesting? So I think a bit of curiosity is really important in this, that we be very kind to ourselves as we start to explore our history and really start just journaling it and getting really clear about where we've been, the stories that have kept us there, and whether or not they serve us, and if we want to move in a different direction.
That's important. So journaling is one. Is there a second or a third you'd like to talk about?
The other thing is, I think it's important to find advocates and support. So if you're wanting to learn about your money history, find a friend or a spouse or a family member and actually do this together. So you've got somebody, an accountability buddy that can call you out on your stuff when you're saying, oh, I always save my money. Like, no, you don't. You just did this the other day, right? Or call them out on their reframes when they're, I'm broke. Well, actually, are you broke? And so being accountable to another person is a really great way to do that. It's important, I think, to find allies. If you don't know a lot about finances, reach out to a financial advisor or somebody that's good with money. Sometimes that's not your family. and start to get informed. A lot of people don't want to do the reading. So listen to an audiobook, watch a video. There's a lot of great information out there, and there are great resources to start to educate yourself.
That's huge. Now, how has your background as a CPA helped you in developing this philosophy?
Well, I think what